gentlemen, here at Talk Art, we recognize that people face hardships. They do. As a matter of fact, you might even call some of them talk hardships. Yeah. Talk about that. You know, it's easy to give up in life sometimes. Don't boo me. I will cry right in front of you. I have very little to live for. It is. It's easy to give up in life. Don't make me give up. And you know, there are those people out there, though, who rise to the occasion. You know, and they share something special that inspires us. And ladies and gentlemen, these are the people that we at Talk Art like to call modern day miracle rap.
You know, Jamie, I'm a miracle.
Sure, Kevin, yeah, you're a real miracle. All right, now, ladies and gentlemen, shit is getting crazy. We are, tonight gonna celebrate some of those modern day miracles. And the people that we are bringing out, these are guests that we've got coming up that have experienced extreme adversity. And they really deserve a big round of applause when they come out, and they deserve your support as audience members. Are you guys on board with that? Yeah. Woo!
Sure thing, Jamie, but first, tell me how good I am at cleaning glass.
Well, Kevin, you sure know how to clean a glass.
All right. Okay. Thanks, Jamie. That's very handsome of you to say. All right, let's go ahead and read these out. I have them on an index card. Our first guest comes all the way from Dayton, Ohio. He's been married for 25 years. And get this, he's blind! What the fuck? Ladies and gentlemen, Alan Babinski.
Oh, Alan. Thanks so much for joining us on the show today.
Good to be here, Jamie.
All right, Alan, would you tell us a little bit about your story?
Well, sure. I met my wife at Mather High School right here in Chicago. We didn't get married until after college, though, but yeah, it's a pretty simple falling in love story.
And you are blind?
Yes, I've been blind since birth.
And you're married?
I believe I just said that, yes.
That is truly a miracle!
I guess.
Wow, you can't trust me. That is amazing.
Wow.
And you know what, actually now, we'd actually love to take some questions from our audience. Is there anyone that has a question for Alan? Sure, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Question, Kevin, Jamie, big fan of the show, guys.
Well, thank you.
I love the orchestra.
Yeah, absolutely, they're fantastic.
That's the best.
My question is for the blind guy.
Oh yeah, that's Alan.
Blind man, were you blind before you got married? And a second question, who do you prefer, Ray Charles or Stevie Wonder?
Okay, well, first of all, yes, I knew I was blind before I got married, because as I said, I was blind since birth. And second of all, are you only asking me if I like Ray Charles or Stevie Wonder because they're blind?
That's prejudice.
Yes, I am.
You're the audience, we're the show.
I think she thinks this is real.
Go ahead, Alan. Can you answer that question here?
Ray Charles.
Oh, great.
Fantastic. And Kevin, who's our next guest?
Sure thing, Jamie. I'll go ahead and do that for you. But first, tell me I'm really awesome with the ladies.
All right, Kevin, you're really awesome with the ladies.
Thank you so much, Jamie. That's very handsome of you to say. Our next miracle guest was born in the United States in 1965 and has one hell of a personality. It's Bounty Paper Towel.
So much for joining us on the show. tell us a little bit about your story.
Sure thing, Jamie. Some people over at Procter & Gamble manufactured me. They call me Quicker Picker Upper.
That's weird. I always thought the quicker picker-upper was cocaine.
You, correct me if I'm wrong, you can absorb things.
Yeah, paper towels.
That is amazing. You know, I would love I would love to take some questions out. Does anybody in the audience have a question for Mountie? Oh, yes, you, sir.
Hey, Jamie and Kevin. Hey, Mr. Towel Guy. I have a question for the Mountie Paper Towel. So my girlfriend just broke up with me for Kim Kardashian. I'm just wondering.
Tonight's guest.
Yeah, I know. Can you absorb pain?
Oh. No, you freak! My paper towels! By the way, I ordered a coffee half an hour ago! Can I get that or not? Oh, hey, Jamie! Check this shit out! Watch me absorb these hookers! Hey! Hey, baby! Want me to wipe that schmutz off your face?
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, I can do that! Because I'm paper towels! Don't make a liar out of me! That's so smooth!
Thank you so much, man!
Sure thing, Jamie, but, first of all, tell me that I dance like those girls from the movie The Black Swan. Tell me how good of a dancer I am.
Well, Kevin, you dance just like the girls in that movie, The Black Swan.
Thank you so much. Our final miracle guest comes to us from right here in Chicago, Illinois. He is an elementary school teacher who's been suffering from pancreatic cancer for the last 10 years. He has climbed Mount Kilimanjaro, ran 2 marathons with a prosthetic limb, and last week he found out that he totally beat his cancer. Yes. Let's hear it for our final guest, David Cohen.
David, thanks so much for joining us on the show. I would love it if you would tell us a little bit about your story.
Yeah, thank you so much. I'm really, truly excited to be here. In 2003, I was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. I've been suffering with it for the last 10 years of my life.
We lost Patrick Swayze.
Yeah, it's
never heard of him.
he was in some movies. Anyway, I'm sorry, I'm a little nervous. I became an elementary school teacher even though I was sick. I started exercising and working out a lot.
Okay.
And I ran a couple of marathons and climbed Mount Kilimanjaro, so I'm like really excited to be here. I'm just so happy to be alive. And thank you so much for having me here on your show.
Sure, sure. Now I also heard this. You drove yourself here today.
I drove myself.
Wow! That is amazing. You know, actually, I would love to just, let's see if we have any other questions here for David Cohen from our audience.
Yeah, I have a question.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, hey, Kevin.
Hey.
Can get you on the real tip.
Hey, how you doing? Yeah. You doing, stranger?
Yeah. I actually have a question for the audience member who had a question.
Me?
No, the second guy.
Oh, yeah. That's this guy.
Hey, are you more second? Yeah. Are you more upset that your wife left you for Kim Kardashian or that she wouldn't have a threesome with you?
That's a really good question. Probably a bit of both.
Threesome.
I think so.
The threesome.
Yeah.
Okay, do you have a question for David Cohen?
Yeah, sure. David Cohen, since you beat pancreatic cancer, what are you most excited about?
Oh my God, that's a wonderful question. I'm just so excited to be here and be alive and be with
you. Oh, somebody's knocking on the talk card door.
Oh, looks like, ladies and gentlemen, we have got a surprise guest. Come on in.
Hey, how's it
He's the man, he's the miracle man. Funny story about my miracle. Not a miracle. Yeah, here's the thing. You know how I said you didn't have cancer? You do.
Oh no.
Yeah, funny, right? It's all in you. It's spreading.
That's not fun.
You're gonna die soon, very soon.
The show was free for you.
Unlike my cancer treatment.
Well, now, Dr. Rabbit, how long have you actually been a doctor?
All my life.
You know what's funny, too? I don't actually see a prosthetic limb. Yeah, there's no, it's real.
Well, that is amazing. You